The former ambassador involved in negotiating the Cordoba agreements does not advocate Spain letting go of its claim over Gibraltar. This will always be Spain's ultimate objective. He is, however, of the belief that good relations and citizens need to come first, and that a hard line achieves nothing.
Well, what I want is really to push the people to create confidence measures, confidence-building measures. I think what we need is to eliminate mistrust between the people of Campo and Gibraltar and between Spain and Gibraltarians. The main issue, of course, goes with the United Kingdom, but we have many, many possibilities to create a good atmosphere which will facilitate agreements good for both parties.
In his article in El País, Josep Pons describes Miguel Ángel Moratinos as a first foreign minister in Spain to move away from a status quo and sign on to action under the principle that if it's possible, you need to act to achieve it. The historical context, according to Mr. Pons, is that while Castilla managed to achieve placing self-determination at the UN within the UK-Spain negotiations in its quest towards territorial integrity, he made the mistake of closing the frontier as a reaction to the 1967 referendum, believing then it went against UN doctrine. This, claims Josep Pons, had the adverse effect of giving the Gibraltarians a national identity they had not had in the past, and fostering resentment. From then on, he claims the Spanish Foreign Ministry nurtured an orthodox doctrine, almost considered sacred, which resulted in an untouchable hard line which was not to be questioned. This again, he says, resulted in a hardened, entrenched position with no leeway for action. These politics, he claims, treated Gibraltarians as squatters to ensure they did not thrive. But at the same time, he adds, a confrontation with the colonial powers, the UK, was avoided. Josep Pons says the cry of Gibraltar Español was shouted at from the rooftops but achieved nothing. The only move was an offer of joint sovereignty and threats of a Spanish flag on the rock. What a way of making friends, claims Mr. Pons in his article. He asks whether anyone seriously thinks an 18th century problem can be resolved now with methods of that time, and whether anyone seriously believes the Gibraltarians will one day wake up and suddenly decide they want to be Spanish.
Of course. We cannot start a war. We cannot try to negotiate a sale of a territory, etc., etc. What we have to do is to find a meeting point for what could be considered a future of good neighborhood and good relationship. And who knows, in the future, one day the people will find that there is no reason to keep a border, to keep something which separates, and people will think in the future that it's better to work for what unites us and not what is separating us.
Josep Pons says he finds it hard to believe how anyone can describe this agreement as a wasted opportunity and a step back. This, he says, could be a question of sour grapes because no one has been able to come up with a better plan. What would be a step back, he says, is for a Spanish government to be forced to push the mantra of Gibraltar Español for the next 300 years.